वेलकम टू क्लास टू ऑफ लोन स्केड्यूल। टुडे विल सी how we can divide one payment into two parts. The installment is XT. This is the notation. Though in most of the problems you will see label installment, you can take X also, but we have to develop using T so that you can use everywhere. Now we have XT, and this XT we want to divide into two parts. Remember in the table, we divided all the installments into two parts, the capital repayment and the interest paid. Okay, what is the capital repayment and what is the interest paid? When we say interest, remember we say this year interest. If your loan outstanding at this time is LT minus 1 and your loan outstanding here is LT, let me write here. Your loan outstanding here after paying this one will be LT, and here at this time your loan outstanding is LT minus 1. Suppose your loan outstanding was 5000 in the last problem, and at this time your loan outstanding is 4181.02. So you didn't pay 818, right? You paid more. You paid 1318.98. This amount you paid. So the difference between the loan outstanding is not the installment, remember. So if you find the difference between this and this, that is the amount you really paid towards your loan repayment. That is called capital repaid. And the interest amount, the extra amount, is called the interest amount, interest paid. So this 500 here, if this amount is this installment at time one, we can say at time t is 1318.98, you can divide this way for the first year, and this is called IT, interest. BT we say here. This is the notation you need to remember. Interest, binterest you can remember. Then capital. Capital is FT, and this XT is the installment. You can remember this too. And if I want to write like this, I can write 1 as well. If you remember for the first year, it was there. So I can write this way. B1, F1, X1. At time 1, the installment paid was X1. And that installment is divided into two parts, B1 and F1. That's all. Similarly, if you want, you can write for the second one, 1318.98. Okay, 418 will go towards B2. B2 will be 418. Similarly, F2. From the table, you can write everything. But we'll have formulas here. Why this is 500? Because this is the amount, interest amount on the loan outstanding last time. So the loan outstanding one LT minus 1 here, that time it was L0. So on this, you multiply with I, 5000 into 0.10, that is 500. So this multiplied by I, this will be BT, interest, okay? So the link is this way, BT is equal to, for every T, T could be 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever you want, you can write BT and FT. What is BT here and what is FT here? एफटी विल बी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द लोन आउटस्टैंडिंग. लॉजिकली आई एम सेइंग, देन विल गो टू मैथमेटिकल वे ऑफ नोइंग. योर लोन आउटस्टैंडिंग डिक्रीज फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर. Why the amount decreased? The reason is we paid some amount. What amount we paid? We didn't pay this amount towards loan repayment. That is what I am saying time and again. We paid this amount towards our loan repayment. So this amount should be the difference between these two. That is the capital repaid. The total installment I am saying, that is XT. Nobody will deny. XT is the total amount. Out of that, what is the interest you paid? Because you have taken the loan, that is 5. What is 500? That is actually ILT minus 1. This formula you can use all the time. Suppose you want to find B1, you write IL naught. B1 will be, for example, B1 will be IL naught. F1 will be L naught minus L1. Sometimes what will happen in most of the problems, if you know the installments, because we first find the installments, you know X1. If you know one of them, you can get the other. It's not that you have to apply the formula separately to find. If you know X1, because X1 is B1 plus F1, why to use formula and take a lot of time, right? If you know B1 and you know X1, if you know B1 and X1, then you can get F1. If you know X1 and B1, you need not apply the formula for F1. That's what I'm saying. You know X1 and F1, you need not apply the formula for B1. When you do a lot of problems, you will be able to know. Similarly, this is for 1 year. For the second year also you can write B2 is IL L1, F2 is L1 minus L2. Remember, the decrease in the loan amount is due to the amount you paid, not the installment you paid. The amount you paid towards your loan repayment. That is something you need to remember. Now we'll do one problem. This is about one installment, okay? Sometimes you must be able to write two or three. Let's do a problem, then we'll go back to the second case. So let me write one example. Remember, there are two cases here. In one case we'll find the loan and the capital repayment for one installment, then for several installments. There are two types of problems and you have to do two types of problems separately. So here loan is suppose 16,000 in some units and the equal installments are 10, okay? That means you have to pay in 10 years. I is given 10%. Then you need to, here I is given 10%, loan is 16,000, I is 10%. You need to find the interest of the fourth payment. The question is find fourth payment. How can you find the interest on the fourth payment? you have to write this way. This is the fourth payment, and here you should know the installment. We'll solve the equation, we'll find that, and then you are supposed to find B4. This is what you need to find. The formula for B4 is IL3. You have to find L3, then you will be able to find B4. To find L3, you should know the instruments first. Okay, so you write the equation, you solve the equation, and then you will be able to find the answer, right? So what should be the formula? First formula, you have to write, you have to find the instrument, right? So let me write the equation. Equation will be, this is 10 years and loan is 16,000. Okay, loan is 16,000. This is L naught, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is 10. I can write this way, 16,000 is equal to, the loan amount is equal to X A10, we know. You solve it, you will be able to know the instrument. The instruments are equal. I need not write X2 here, and that will give me 16,000 divided by A10 at 4%. At 10%, you can see. If you find at 10%, then the answer will be, you can calculate this one. Oh, that's why I'm getting, this is 4% actually. This is 4%, okay. At 4%, if you find X will be equal to the installment amount, equal installment, you found already that one, the answer. Okay, it will take some time for you. Let me write, you can check later. 1972.66. This is the installment here. That installment, I mean, everywhere it's the same. I did not try it everywhere. This installment I need to divide into two parts. Okay, everywhere this is the same installment, IL3. So if you want to find IL3, you need to find L3. I we know 0.04. L3 you need to find. What is L3 here? Loan outstanding at time 3. Okay, so what is loan outstanding at time 3? This is not important now in this problem particularly, because we are not finding the capital repayment. This is not required. So let me find L3 here. L3, when I say, I'll not worry about the first three installments. Okay, L3 means after 3. So this is the installment I need to consider. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, prospectively I am finding L3, loan outstanding at time 3. The installment I know, I found already, 1972.66A7. Do you agree? That is L3. Once you know L3, you just multiply by I, you will get the answer. If you find this one, you will get 11840.01. Okay, this is L3. See, the total loan was 16,000. You paid 3 installments. Now at time 3, your loan outstanding is 11840.01 at time 3. This is the loan outstanding. Okay, now this amount you have to pay in 7 installments, and these are the installments. So if you find the present value of all the 7 installments, you have to get L3. This is the way. Otherwise, using retrospective method also, you can find L3. There are 2 ways, but we are not interested in L3 now. We know already there are 2 methods. We have done it in the last class. In today's class, we are finding B4. B4 will be 4% of this. Okay, So 4% of L3. 4% of L3 is the amount. That amount you will be paying. Okay, you can check it later. That will be 473.60. 473.60 is the amount in some units. That amount you need to pay towards the interest payment, okay, for this year. Here you are finding, right, B4 you are finding for the third year. If you want to find F4, you can apply the formula. You have to find L4 once again. You know already L3, you have to find L4. For that you find, write A6 here, then subtract, you will get this. This is one way, but we will not do it by this way. Already we know the installment, why not use that? Already we know the installment X4, and we know B4. X4 is this one, B4 is this one. You just subtract. If you subtract, you will get this one. Why to apply special formula? Okay, so if you are supposed to find the capital, you need not find it separately. That is what you need to remember. Now let's go back to the next problem. In the next case, we'll see how to find both the capital repayment and interest paid over several installments, not one installment here, several installments. Suppose we have one installment here, one installment here, one installment here. This is time t, or maybe t plus 1 we can take, then t plus 2 here, t plus 3 here. Remember, I am saying the notation. The notations are this: xt plus 1, xt plus 2, xt plus 3. And then if you divide into two parts, here you need to divide into two parts, here you need to divide into two parts, here you need to divide into two parts. What will happen is, all the parts you are dividing, you will get interest every time. Okay, the interest here will be the notation. I am saying bt plus 1, we are considering this group, not one installment. Last time whatever we have done, that was only for one installment, and for that installment we found the interest amount. Now for all installments, we have to find the interest amount and the capital repayment amount. Here this will be ft plus 2, this will be ft plus 3. Okay, let's find the capital first. If you remember the formula separately, if you find ft1 will be by the formula LT minus LT plus 1, FT plus 2 will be LT plus 1 minus LT plus 2, FT plus 3 will be LT plus 2 minus LT plus 3. You have to find this one, you have to find this one, you have to find this one, you have to add everything, because finally we are interested here. These are the two questions, right? If there are several installments, for several installments you find the capital repaid. So instead of finding all, it should take a lot of time. You can cancel this, right? Why to find all? Just find LT minus LT plus 3, that's all. Remember, this is T plus 1. Okay, if I give a problem, suppose 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, four, five. It's a 6 year problem. And you are finding here during the 3 years, what is the capital repaid? Just apply the formula LT minus LT plus 3. T is not 2 here. That is what you need to remember. Okay. Here capital repaid over 3 years will be L1, see LT minus LT plus 3 minus L4. This will be the formula. 1, because I've started from T plus 1. T is here. How T comes, you know? Because this is what we write. See, when you find here, BT is ILT minus 1, FT is LT minus 1 minus LT. Though we are finding a T, T minus 1 is required. Because this difference is the capital repay. LT minus LT plus 3. And there is no special formula to find the interest. If for several installments, 3 or 4 or 5, more than 1, if you are finding, you just add all the installments. In the problems where installments are equal, you can write 3x also. But here, according to notation, I will not write 3x. I will add everything. This would be 3x typically in most of the problems, minus whatever you found here in 1. Okay, if this is f, I will subtract f. That's all. I have no separate formula. So this will be equal to all the installments minus this. Okay, because I can write BT plus 1 is equal to FT plus 1. Sorry, BT plus 1 is XT plus 1. The installment minus FT plus 1. Okay. Similarly, BT plus 2 will be XT plus 2 minus FT plus 2. BT plus 3 will be XT plus 3 minus FT plus 3. So when you add these 3, okay, this one, that will be sum of all 3, that is F I've taken. Sorry, this one I've written, and sum of all 3, that you will get from here anyway, F. You have to subtract. And when you are finding the interest amount, and mostly considering that the installments are equal here, directly we can write, because in 95% of the cases, when you are finding this, you will see the total installment will be 3x, because they will be equal in most cases. Okay, minus this amount, that's all F I've written for that. That amount you need to subtract. That way you will get interest. So first you need to find capital repay, then interest amount. That's all. This is 80% of loan schedule, believe me. But you will have a lot of problems. The more problems you will do, the better way you will learn. And then lot of variety of problems you will be able to solve. So practice is crucial. You have 4-5 days time. You have to complete anyway. Let me do another problem here. Though this is in continuation of the last problem, but we'll do this one also. Yeah, this was the question, right? This was the question, and then we found this one. Here we'll add a little bit more. Okay, you can make it part 1 and part 2. the capital repaid in the last 5 years. Who can answer? Who can answer this? We are talking about single or several installments here. We are talking about several installments here, right? 5 years installment. So the question is, individually you can find, not a problem. But don't you think it will take a lot of time when you do individually? So we'll not do it individually, okay? We'll try to find it. We'll try to find it using the formula. We have a little space, okay? So we'll try to use the formula. Last five years, okay? This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these are the 10 years, last 5 years, 6th year, 7th year, 8th year, 9th year, 10th year. So what is the formula for this one? Suppose you want to find the capital repaid, capital, you remember that way, F6 you need to find. For F6 you need to find L5, L6 you subtract, then you need to find this one, F7. For F7 you need to find L6 minus L7, so you have to find L6, L7. For F8 you need to find L7 minus L8, so for that you need to find L8 once again. Similarly, you need to go to F10. You don't need to find all this, right? You apply the formula, we just derive it. If you go by the formula, directly we'll write, we'll not find individually all these things, okay? You just can write sum F, that is all, or sum Fi, I's 5 to 6 to 10, if you don't worry about the symbols. This will be equal to L5 minus L10, and fortunately L10 is 0 here, because loan outstanding here is 0. If I ask this 3 years, still you need to find L5. When we have these 5 years, L10 is 0, so we need to find only L5, that's all. L5 prospectively you can find, whatever is the installment after 5, installment we already found if you go through that, and these are X, okay? So this is the loan outstanding here, that's all. This is the answer, it's very easy, right? This way you should be able to do the problems. And when you see more problems, and when you do more problems, you learn more. Now I'll do another problem. 900 here, and this is 3. The question says, let me write here, term 3 years, I is 18.5%, quite high interest rate. First of all, anyway, you need to find the monthly installment, okay? That's there. After finding the monthly installment, the problem for you is, calculate the interest and capital portions of the 13th payment. Okay, this is the question. Calculate the interest and capital repayment of 13th payment. If you stick to your symbols, it will be good for you. It will be easy for you. So, never forget the symbols here. This is the loan here. 13th payment. When you say 13th payment, this is your 12th payment now, because these are monthly. Okay, 1 year, then again monthly, 2 year, again monthly, 3 year. So this will be my 13th payment. 13 divided by 12. So what you need to find? Interest and capital. So you find one, then the other you can find. Interest is easier for me. If I write B 13 divided by 12, that will be the loan outstanding here. Okay, here is L1 multiplied by the interest amount for this period. It's no more I, it's I12 by 12. Okay, so I is given, you find I12 by 12. This is the monthly interest, because you are doing monthly. I is given, you find I12 by 12 multiplied by L1. How to find L1? I'll go to that. L1 means for 2 years. First of all, you need to find the installment here. For that, you have two methods. You can use annuity method 1, method 2, whatever is preferable for you. In loan schedule, normally method 1 will be easier for you to work with. However, whatever you wish, you can do that. However, when you go to the next chapter, then PHLE payable annuities will be more useful. You will understand, you will do by both the methods, whatever way you like, you can do that. But let's find the installments here. The equation you need to solve is this one. If you are equating 900 to, there are 36 payments, okay? X36 if I write, I have to change I. You know how to do that. Monthly installments, there are 36 months, and I you have to find here. That I will be I12 by 12. And with this I have to solve this, then you will get X. This is one way. Other way is this. 12X you need to write, 3 years and 12 payments. Whatever way you do, finally you should be able to get I. Once you get I, then, once you get X, then you can proceed further. X is 32.13. You can check it. X is, if you solve this, X will be 32.13. So we know the monthly installments. Monthly you have to pay 32.13 pounds, so that you will be able to pay 900 pounds. Okay, 32 every month. So 32 into 36, when you multiply, this should be more than 900 anyway. Now L1 you need to find. What is the difference between the total loan and L1? This is L0 actually. L0 is 900, right? So if you find L1, I12 by 12 also we have here, if you are doing by this method, I already we have. And L1 if you write, X, A24 you have to write, that's all, right? 2 years. 24 means, this X amount already you know, 32.13, and A24 you find, the present value of all the 24 payments, that is the loan outstanding here. So loan outstanding here is important. If you are finding the interest payment here, if you know the interest payment here, you need not find the capital repayment separately. This will be equal to the total installment, that is 32.13. okay, at this point all are equal here, minus whatever you get here, this answer A. When you subtract, you will get this one. Separately you need not find. So remember, if you use the symbol like 13 by 12, it will be easier for you. If you write 13 also, it's fine, but make it sure you will not make a mistake. These are the simple problems you need to know. Now let's move to the last part. This is called APR. Okay, APR. APR is like I. Annualized percentage rate of interest, APR. Okay, this is like I. But we round it all the time. We'll go to rounding later. But before going to APR, because we will compare flat rate and API. You need to know what is flat rate of interest. Flat rate sometimes is easy because you can't explain effective interest rate. In effective interest rate, we see the time period also. So sometimes it brings complexity, right? Because you are giving importance to each time period. So you have to consider the interest separately. You have to learn annuity and everything. So it takes a lot of time. Okay. So if you want, you are giving loan to someone or for any reason, for a driver, okay, he wants to purchase a car or auto, it will be very difficult for them to understand, right? You can say this way, this is a simple one. You just divide monthly, okay? Suppose we have 2 years, 24 payments. You give a loan of 2000 and you say them to pay 100 each year, 100 each month, okay? 100 each month. So let me write 1 by 12, 2 by 12, 100 each month. So in total, as a part of bank, I'll receive 2400. If that guy says, see, you are asking from me 100 per month, I will end up paying 2400, but you are paying 2000 for me to purchase something. Are you not taking more? I will say, yes, I'm taking more because I'm part of the bank. That is my business. If I get that 400 extra, that amount will go to the office rent, that amount will go to the staff cost, and from that amount only we'll find our bread and butter, because this is my business. We'll take 400 more from you. So what is the interest rate? If you want to find APR or effective rate of interest, I have to solve this one, you know, or maybe a 24, whatever you write, you multiply by 12 here. There are two methods, okay? I have to multiply by 12 here, or you write this way also, and then whatever interest rate is given accordingly, you can solve this one. You will find I, what is the interest rate you are charging. But that kind of interest rate I might not be able to explain to my customers. So to make things easier, I can say this way: what is the total amount you are paying? 2400. The total amount is 2400. If I write x here, for 2 years it will be 24x. What is the loan amount? L naught, you subtract, that is 400, right? So this is easy. This is flat rate. That's all. 400 is the flat rate. This is easy, or solving this one is easy. Not for you, for the common man who never studied mathematics. Okay, when we say APR, you have to solve this equation. 2000 is equal to 100, A24. You need to solve. You need a calculator and all that. 1 minus V24 by I, all that you need to write. So there you get effective interest rate. That is only APR. We just round it off. We will not say you have to pay 23, 24, 25, 26. We will not say this. So this amount will not be able to pay. So you have to round it off. Okay. You should not take after some digits. The rounding is APR. APR is just, I remember, it's not a new one. New one is this flat rate. So flat rate is 400, remember. However, when we find I here solving this equation, I is per annum. Here we have 2 years. You have to divide it by 2 so that you will get per annum. Also, if you remember, I is the interest rate per unit amount of money. So the total amount is 2000, so you have to divide 2000 here. You get unit amount of money. So now the flat rate is flat rate per annum. I've divided by 2. Okay, it's for 2 years flat rate 400. Per year flat rate is 200. But 200 is for 2000 per unit amount. This will be 400 divided by 4000. That is 1 divided by 100, 10%, okay? This is 1 upon 10. 1 upon 10 is 10%. 10% is the flat interest rate. When we say flat interest rate, because we will compare with this I, with APR normal one, normal I, effective interest rate, you have to find per year. Suppose this arrangement is for 10 years, you have to divide by 10. Suppose you have 20,000 amount, you have to write 20,000 here. 20,000 will come here also, sorry, here. And the total amounts you have to write here. We'll have simple problems where the amounts are given, you have to find effective interest rate, or effective rate is given, you have to find flat interest rate. I can give a simple problem where I is given, you have to find flat interest rate or installments, okay? Suppose I write a question like this. The loan amount is 5,000. Number of years 5. In 5 years you need to pay 5,000. Installments are monthly. Okay, so 5,000, 5 years installment are monthly. And the installments are also, I will provide you. No, this is already done, right? If installments are provided like 100, you can find both, you can find I and flat interest rate. We'll not provide installments, okay? We'll provide you flat interest rate, fine installment. We'll provide you flat rate of interest. Flat rate is 8%. Instead of installments, I will say find the effective interest rate, find APR. This can be a question. So here what you can do is, flat rate you have to use. Flat rate formula is the total loan amount minus, how many months are there? 12 into 5, 60 months are there, okay? 60 into installment is X divided by 5,000, the loan amount into number of years 5, and this is given 8%. 0.08 is equal to 5,000 minus 6X divided by 25,000. Okay, so what is 25,000 into 8? Who can answer? What is 25 into 8?
2 lakhs.
Okay, 2 lakhs I can write. It's 0.08, right? I'm not saying 25,000 into 8, it's into 0.08. It's like 250 into 8. 2000, right? If I'm wrong, you can correct me. So what is X here? 500, right? Then you have to find APR. So the installments are monthly, and you know this amount. This amount is 5,000. These are 500 if I am correct. Okay, you check it if this is not correct. Then write equation of value. Because we are finding I, flat rate is given. From flat rate we found the installments. From installments you have to find effective interest rate. Okay. 2500A512. You solve this equation, find I and round it off. That is APR. Find I, that is effective interest rate, then solve it, then round it off, you will get APR also. That's all. Class is over for today. Thank you.